Well, today I want to tell you the stories of two different moms. One is a stay-at-home mom who dreads dinner almost every single day, and the other was a working mom with zero energy to tackle supper when she gets home. But both made some simple changes, and now they cook at home almost every single day. Let's talk more about that coming up next. Well, hi, I'm Dawn from The Minimal Mom. If we haven't met before, I am married to Tom and we have four kids, ages 4 through 9. And we aim to live a minimalist lifestyle. Basically, we've highly simplified our house, and what we found is that almost everything goes better now that our house is simplified, especially things like dinner time. And so, like I said, we have four kids, and since becoming a mom, I've had just about every position possible, from full-time working mom with kids in daycare to full-time stay-at-home mom to part-time work-at-home mom to now full-time work-at-home mom. And what I found at every stage was that I never enjoyed cooking at any of them. I never found it to be easy or enjoyable, and most days it was just always hanging over my head thinking, oh, I really need to go get dinner going. No, now stop what you're doing. Go make supper. But what I have found is that by making a few simple changes, now we cook at home almost all of the time. And it's really nice because I just don't have that guilt of spending money that we shouldn't be eating out, of knowing that we could be using that money to eat healthier at home. So let's get started talking about how we can get rid of all of that guilt. The first step is to take a really close look at where the breakdown is occurring. A lot of times we'll just say, oh, I'm just not organized, or I'm lazy, or things about ourselves that aren't actually true. But what we really need to do is just take a really close look at the dinner process and pinpoint the problem. So let's look at all of the different steps that actually go into making dinner. I think most of us would agree that it starts with meal planning. And so I have a separate video on my simple meal planning system. Basically, if we're trying to get back on track with cooking, let's look at like a 2-week menu rotation and have them be meals that are really familiar to you and easy to cook. But I cover this in more depth in my meal planning video, so be sure to check that out as well. It also has a free printable inventory sheet that so many of you have said have been really helpful. So I'm really glad to hear that. So then step two is having to buy the groceries. I know for me that when I was working, this was a big breakdown for me because sometimes we'd go on the weekends, sometimes I'd have to stop after work, but I always had other things I needed to be doing as well, or I just didn't feel like it. So I've talked about Instacart has been a game changer for me. So many of you had said that you really enjoy the Walmart pickup service. So there's tons of different things available. Find what fits into your budget or is available in your area. And if grocery shopping is where the breakdown is, I think it's worth investing into that system because, like for us, eating out one time pretty much pays for my Instacart delivery, right? So by having our groceries delivered, it has significantly increased the amount that we cook at home. All right, the third step is actually cooking itself. And so like I said, I am with you. If you get home at the end of the day and you are just tired and the last thing that you wanna do is to cook a full meal, I know it is so much easier just to go through McDonald's or some other fast food place or order takeout, whatever your thing is. And so even for myself now, what I have to do is I have to start dinner at breakfast or at lunchtime. I'm home, so I have the luxury of doing it at lunchtime as well, but if you have to leave to go to work, then definitely at breakfast. Now, I'm gonna do a whole separate video on this about how we can be really consistent and successful with starting dinner at breakfast time, so I'm not gonna share all of that right now, but definitely when I get up in the morning, one of the things that I do when I'm thinking through my day is I have to know what we're making for dinner that night, and then I think about anything that I can do to prep it, whether it's cooking the meat or chopping up some vegetables. I've even found just getting the pots and pans out that I'm gonna use, having them on the stove, setting out the ingredients next to it. When I get home and I see that that prep work has already been done, I'm much more likely to stick with it. And then another thing I do to help ease the stress at the end of the day for cooking a meal is I cook big batches of meat. So anytime I'm cooking meat, almost always I'm cooking extra because that's the part that seems to take the longest, at least for me. So I'll do a separate video about that as well. And then we have to serve the food and clean up. Now, I've started involving my family in this a lot more. I know for a while, we were in that stage where it was just easier for me to do it myself. But now that the kids are getting a little bit older, they love setting the table. And so we used to just sit at the counter a lot of times to have supper. But now we've decided that if I'm gonna go through the work of cooking, and if it's a night when we're all home, then we're gonna set the table and we're gonna sit at the table and enjoy the time together. I know it's hard with sports and activities and homework and all of that stuff, but it has been actually really cool just to hear like the conversations that come up and see how we've connected more as a family now that we've been eating at the table. And we don't do it every night, but pretty much every night the kids are asking if we're going to sit at the table, and they fight over who gets to set it and then clean up as well. Like I said, sometimes it's easier just to do it myself, but I found that even just having the kids helping to clean up, it's kind of nice not being alone and feeling like I'm the only one doing it. So I let them help and they can load and unload the dishwasher. They can scrape their plates into the garbage. They can take stuff off of the table. They're surprisingly helpful, even our 4-year-old. So I would encourage you to get your kids helping as well, even if it means you have to, you know, rearrange your dishes and put some in lower cabinets so they're more accessible or different things like that. And kids need to feel needed, right? Kids need to know that they have a role in our family and that they're needed and they're useful and they're helpful. It's helping to establish their identities. So that's another reason why it might be worth going a little bit out of your way to involve your kids in it as well, even if they are going to grumble about it. And my last tip, and probably the biggest tip, I don't know, maybe I should have put this at the beginning, is to simplify your kitchen. You're probably not surprised to hear me say that, but I know I didn't used to like my kitchen. The drawers and doors and everything was jam-packed. There was piles of stuff on the counter. It was not an enjoyable place to work, and it wasn't a fun place to hang out in, so I just avoided it. But I've definitely found since we simplified our kitchen that I don't mind cooking as much. Dishes don't take as long. It's easy to find the pots and pans that I'm looking for. They're usually clean, which is super cool. So maybe part of the reason you're not cooking at home is because your kitchen is not a pleasant place to be. And of course, I have a video about simplifying your kitchen, so it might be worth checking that out as well. And then one other thing is to decide how many times a week your family can eat out. You know, if you're eating out a bunch right now, to go to zero probably isn't practical. So maybe you go to 3 times and then to 2 times and then to 1 time. For us, we try to limit it to 1 time where we eat out as a family, usually just out at a fast food place unless we have a gift card. And then about every 2 weeks, Tom and I will go out for dinner. So that's really nice for me because those are times I don't feel guilty about it. It's planned in and we're all on the same page about it. And so it's a nice treat, right? When we do it. And then coming up in this series, we'll talk about how I've really simplified things with my Instant Pot. I know a lot of us have them, but don't know what to cook in it or even how to use it. So I'll share some of my favorite recipes for the Instant Pot because that has made a huge difference. And what to do if you're just not at home when it's dinner time. We've developed a really simple system to be able to take meals to go that has been working very well. We'll also talk about batch cooking meat, said how you can be consistent and successful with prepping your dinner in the morning before you leave for the day. So all those videos will be coming up. So I hope you subscribe so that you're notified when they are released. I would love to know your favorite tips for being more successful with cooking at home. You always have really great tips. Or if you have any questions around this, please share those as well. A thumbs up is the best compliment that you can give us. And I will look forward to visiting with you again really soon. Now go get dinner started.